Welcome to this week's edition of Ice Time Online with Peoria Journal Star beat writer Dave Minion. My name is Brendan Burke. Plenty of stuff going on the show today.
We've got an interview with Kevin McDonald. He's the director of pro scouting for the St. Louis Blues and the Riverman general manager. Then we'll take you inside the Riverman locker room and we'll let your emails be answered by Ben Bishop. And then we'll roll out with an interview with Eddie Belfour, future Hall of Fame goaltender and now the Riverman goaltending coach.
And we'll do this every week, and you can submit your questions to us, whether it's for one of the players or for one of us, to radio@riverman.net. We're here with Riverman general manager and director of pro scouting for the St. Louis Blues, assistant general manager as well, Kevin McDonald. A lot of titles for you, Kevin, but the Blues sent down Lars Eller after calling him up, and he got his first NHL goal in his first NHL game. Obviously, for a young guy, just 20 years old, there are a lot of pluses to Lars Eller, and nice to see him getting a call here in the early part of the season.
Yeah, I mean, this is what he dreams about, so he's got his first five NHL games in, gave the team a lift, scored a power play goal, and, you know, and the Blues management's been consistent. If guys aren't playing up there, they want to get him right back here. This will be a great building block for him now. You know, it's preseason game, training camp. You know, now to get an NHL regular season game, get a feel for just how fast it is, what's expected, I think it'll translate into him being a better player down here and be more prepared for the next time he goes up.
The Blues and the Rivermen have an interesting situation that isn't the same way in every other organization, where when somebody needs to get called up, it's not always a clear cut who it's going to be. There's a lot of different options on this team, and that has to help inspire these guys at this American Hockey League level that, hey, if you're playing well, you could be next.
Absolutely. I mean, since we came here, this is what we've tried to do. Like, you know, it's important. We always fell for the players. We asked these guys to go through the wall, play for, you know, every shift, earn their ice time. But the flip side is if you beat out your peers here and there's a need, then you go. And that's, we've tried to stay very consistent with that over the years. I think we've done a real good job with that. And it's very encouraging for the players. It's like, you know, it makes them, you can't get down on your play. You have to get excited. You have to be ready for the next game, turn the page, because, you know, we've seen some unfortunate injuries spring up. You just never know when there's going to be a need and when someone's going to go up to the, you know, the call is going to come to myself and Davis or who, you know, who we recommend. And, you know, it's right there for these guys every night just to beat out their peers, and you're one call away.
Success in St. Louis and success in Peoria often go hand in hand, and I think for the first time in a few years, Blues fans can get excited about the guys in Peoria, because a guy like Lars Eller wouldn't have been here maybe last year or the year before, because there's finally that depth in the St. Louis Blues system to push some of those premier prospects and those first-round guys and send them here to Peoria to develop in the way that you guys want to.
You know, same thing with Aaron Peluzia and Brett Sone, and, you know, the rules don't allow Pietrangelo to come down, but this is great. This is what the American League is partially here for. What Peoria is partially here for is to combine that winning environment, the development, and give the, you know, as you and I know, this is a great league, the American League. It's a great test for these guys to figure out how close they are to being ready to actually play in the NHL. And we're excited to have some real good young players down here.
All right, Kevin, thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.
First question is from Jason from Creve Coeur, and he asked, what is it like working with Ed Belfour as a goalie coach? And it's really good. He's been up here a couple times so far this year, and you know he's one of the best ever to play the game. So to get a chance to learn from him and work with him on the ice, it's a lot of fun, and it's a lot of hard work, but it's really good for me. And the second question is from Matt from Peoria, and he writes, does being tall help you in goal, or does it make it more difficult? And some might argue both ways, but I'd like to think it makes it that it helps me. You know, try to take up as much net as possible, and you know, being tall, I get to take up a little bit more net when I'm going down and across. So I like to think it makes it a little bit easier, and I try to make it help my game as much as possible.
Ice Time Online here. We're with former Chicago Blackhawks goaltender Eddie Belfour and Coach Belfour now.
Yep. New position, new role. I'm looking forward to learning the new role, and I've had fun with it so far. The young guys are real motivated. They've worked real hard, and that's really nice to see.
Watching you work with Hannu Toivonen and Ben Bishop in practice, you've got some interesting drills that you have them doing.
Well, I think for myself, over the years, I found success in doing drills, you know, that were game-like drills. and situations that happen a lot in a game. And that was my first goalie coach was Vladislav Trecek, and that was his philosophy, was to do a lot of drills that were game-like situations and a lot of hard work. And I think when you combine those two of hard work and where it turns out you're going to get tired and you have to build the endurance, it's a lot like what happens in a game.
He meant a lot to your career, Tretiak, didn't he? I think you told me a story about being very aware of him in the grandstand when you were over in Europe playing in juniors.
Had a chance to play for Team Canada, and we traveled a lot. And when we were playing one of the tours that we went on, we were playing a Russian team, and he was at a couple of the games, and that made knowing that he was in the stands made it very motivating for me to play the best I could, because he was obviously a childhood hero growing up in Canada for myself. And to get to work with him and get to know him, and he's a great friend of mine. It was just a great time and great feeling.
Have you told him yet that you're coaching?
No, we haven't talked yet. I know he's been real busy with the Hockey Federation over there, and hopefully we'll get a chance in the near future to catch up. I know he visits every once in a while, and I'm hoping that we can do that.
You're working with two young goaltenders here. What do you think you have in Bishop and Toivonen?
Well, they're both very big goalies. Ben being 6'7", and Hanu 6'3", 6'4". Hanu is very flexible, and he has some very good qualities. He's a very good positional goaltender. Ben plays the puck very well, and they both really work hard. They're very motivated. So I've seen them improve from the start of the season quite a bit, both of them. And I'm hoping that they'll get an opportunity to get back to the NHL.